I use VimWiki, so everything I ever need to remember can be easily accessed without taking my hands off the keyboard. I just open up a terminal, enter Vim, hit the leader key combination, and I'm right in my own personal wiki. I can even maintain a work journal with another quick combination, and boom, a new diary page is ready for info. And because they're all just text files, it's trivial to sync them with other devices, such as my phone. It's kind of like magic, and today, I'll show you how I set it up. Greetings, and welcome to another Vimtastic episode of Veronica Explains. I'm Veronica, and today I'm going to show you how I use VimWiki to keep a personal wiki filled with notes, tasks, a work diary, and the scripts from these videos. I've used VimWiki for a number of years now to organize my thoughts right from the terminal. And because it's just generating a bunch of text files, it pairs nicely with file sync programs. Now, if you just want written instructions for how I set this up, I've got a blog post over on my website, vkc.sh. And I'll also be doing a VimWiki Q&A stream shortly for patrons and Ko-fi supporters who make unsponsored videos like these possible. The GitHub for VimWiki, where you can download the package and view the official instructions, is at github.com/VimWiki/VimWiki. Now, you can use VimWiki with either Vim or NeoVim, but I tend to prefer using Vim because I'm old and it's what I know. And as VimWiki is just a plugin, the process of procuring the package is predicated primarily on your personal plugin provider preferences. Now, I tend to use the native Vim packages instead of a third-party package manager because it enables easily updating your plugins from source via Git. If you want to see a future video about Vim plugins, you should make sure to, hang on, I can't read the teleprompter. Insert comment farming banter here. To start with, I'm going to set three prerequisites in VimRC. Set no compatible allows enhancements to Vim that aren't compatible with the older V implementation. File type plugin on enables loading plugins for specific file types. And syntax on makes sure that syntax highlighting is set as expected by VimWiki. Then just save and quit Vim. If we re-enter the file, we can see that syntax highlighting is working as expected. Now, since I'm using the native Vim packages, I can simply follow the directions on GitHub and clone the repo into my Vim plugins directory. Then we can run Vim real quick with the help tags option to rapidly generate documentation for VimWiki. And that's it. VimWiki's installed now, and I didn't need an external package manager. Of course, if you prefer to use a package manager, that's an option. VimWiki is packaged all over the place and shouldn't be too hard to integrate into your existing config. I've used it with Pathogen and VimPlug in the past, and it was fine. It's just that now that Vim has its own native packaging solution, for me, that's just what I prefer. Once it's installed, relaunch Vim, and you can now enter VimWiki anytime Vim is open with the command sequence /ww. Backslash, of course, being the default leader key, which is a special key in Vim that you can allocate to plugins. The first time you run VimWiki, it will prompt you to make a new directory. And if you aren't importing existing notes, that default directory is probably fine. That said, you can customize this directory in VimRC, and I'll show you that in a minute. When it creates a new directory, it drops you into a blank index file. Think of this as the root of your wiki. Here you can write something in your wiki, and then when you save the file, a .wiki file is generated inside the VimWiki subdirectory of your home folder. It'll save the files here, regardless of where you were when you started Vim, and to me, I think that's pretty nice. By default, VimWiki uses a custom syntax, which admittedly isn't my favorite, and I typically swap it to Markdown. and I'll show you how I do that in a minute. MediaWiki is also a syntax option, but I personally prefer Markdown since it pairs well with external applications. With the default syntax, surrounding a header with these equal sign wings will create a highlighted header, and using dual square brackets will create a link. VimWiki fully supports creating folders and customizing a file name with the familiar Markdown-like syntax, putting the file path first, then a pipe, followed by the friendly name of the link. In normal mode, bringing the cursor to a link and pressing Enter will automatically create a new document. It's pretty slick. Lists are straightforward, and list items should be automatically generated. And you can pretty much put any text in here that you want. A neat feature is that you can make checkboxes with single square brackets with a space in the middle. And then from normal mode, if you hit Control Space, that's going to check them off from anywhere on that line. And you can even nest those checkboxes and make little in-progress indicators inside the parent checkbox. What I like about this approach to note-taking, using the terminal instead of a GUI application like Obsidian, is that for me, it often feels less cluttered to keep the interface intentionally simple. The text is all the same size, and there's no graphics, no big headers, no lists of hashtags, no tree view getting in my mind's way. Plus, I'm already in Vim anyway, as it's my editor of choice, so the idea of simply dropping into VimWiki from whatever I'm working on is effectively seamless. And because it's Vim, the customization options are nearly endless. There's no way I could ever cover every single customization, but I'll share the two VimWiki-specific customization options that I use every day in my work. Adding customizations is done with a dictionary in the VimWiki underscore list global, which you can update in your VimRC. Here, for instance, I've modified the syntax to be Markdown because I spend much more time working in Markdown, and it's just an easier default for me. This involves modifying two variables in the list: syntax, which will assign the value markdown, and ext, which will assign the value md. This should tell VimWiki to create markdown files and assign them the .md extension. Now, while I prefer Markdown, there is a benefit to using the default VimWiki syntax instead, and that's the built-in HTML converter. See, you can easily generate an HTML version of your wiki thanks to the VimWiki all to HTML command. And you can serve this however you'd like, but only if you use the default syntax and not Markdown or MediaWiki. That said, there's no shortage of powerful tools to turn Markdown into web pages, and it's pretty trivial to use VimWiki along with whatever static site generator you prefer. Maybe I'll make a video about that someday. Another customization that I typically make is to change the default VimWiki folder to match my existing Nextcloud Notes folder. Nextcloud is a cool, self-hosted alternative to Dropbox or Google Drive, and it has a perfectly reasonable notes application that can easily sync across all of my devices, including a native Android application. This gives me rapid access to my VimWiki Markdown files from virtually anywhere on the planet. I can write a note on my phone using the Nextcloud Notes app, and within seconds, it's available right in VimWiki. And aside from Nextcloud, there's all sorts of reasons you might want to use a custom path for your wiki. And luckily, doing so is pretty straightforward. We just add another dictionary item to the VimWiki underscore list global, this time using path as the key, and in my case, because I'm using Nextcloud, /Nextcloud/notes as the value. Of course, you should replace that directory with whatever makes sense for you and your needs. And if you're like me and regularly using Markdown outside of VimWiki, you might want to add another option to VimRC to restrict VimWiki to just the paths that we've set here. You can do that with the global variable VimWiki underscore global underscore ext, which you can set to 0. This will restrict VimWiki's operation to only those paths listed in VimRC, which can make the navigational tools a bit more succinct. Navigational tools like searching your wiki for specific text. Because these are ultimately just text files, you can find notes by any Unix-friendly means that you have at your disposal. Loads of people use ripgrep for this, and that's a fine option. But VimWiki helpfully includes a search feature to search your entire wiki for a specific string, and that's VimWiki search, or helpfully, VWS. From VimWiki, in normal mode, simply hit colon, then capital VWS, and then type the search pattern that you're looking for. VimWiki will automatically parse this through your entire wiki, and you can go back and forth between matches using lnext and lprevious. And aside from search, there's a bunch of useful navigation built into VimWiki. When Vim is in normal mode, Tab and Shift Tab will function like they do in a web form and jump you from one link to the next on your page. The Backspace key goes back a link in your wiki, kind of like having a back button for your notes. And if you're a TabStack Vim user, you can open the index in a new tab with leader.wt, leader being set as default to the backslash key. And you can look at all of the VimWiki key bindings with the VimWiki-mappings help option. Some of these bindings might conflict with your terminal's defaults, though, so luckily it's all very customizable. My favorite option here is leader.w, which opens a new diary wiki file, already named with the current date on it. I use this all the time as a work journal, keeping notes about phone calls, infrastructure bugs, and even shopping lists. And because I sync it all with Nextcloud Notes, it's pretty much always at my fingertips if I'm away from my computer. VimWiki's been critical infrastructure for my brain for a while now. I know about 1,000 commenters are probably clacking away right now, wondering why I don't use Obsidian or Evernote or something else. And as always, you should use what you like. Years ago, learning Vim broke my brain, and now whenever I don't have a modal editor, I'm missing it. But even if those fancy GUI tools supported a Vim binding, I don't think I'd be all that interested in switching, when Vim and VimWiki pretty much do exactly what I want right now. It's just text, distraction-free. Those fancier tools are great, but in my opinion, it's a little like comparing a blockbuster motion picture to a good book. I mean, both are nice, don't get me wrong, but I know that I want to spend less time being dazzled and more time with my own imagination. Maybe you do too. 1, 2, 3, 4! From VimWiki. I'm going to keep saying VimWiki, aren't I?